notice is that business at the port of Mombasa has been paralyzed again. Now, this after truck drivers down their tools, protesting against new directives by the government. The transporters along the northern corridor from Mombasa at the coast to Malaba at the Ugandan border have parked their trucks again, and this is affecting the movement of cargo along the corridor. Now, the reason is very simple. These guys are saying they want the 2012 task force on long distance road safety be implemented, which calls for reduction of roadblocks, creation of special police to monitor unworthy vehicles, and cut back on the cumbersome clearing procedures at the different borders. Listen, I do not know whether you have been to these borders, but I was recently at one of them, and it was Malaba. So I mounted a truck that was crossing from Kenya into Uganda, and I tell you what, this truck spent almost 5 hours. For the time that we are at the border, 5 hours, the truck was not moving. When it moved past the first clearing point, just about what, 5 minute drive, you are at the next weighing bridge. Again, you have to spend more time there because already there are more trucks on the line waiting to be cleared. The whole conversation about these guys and their strike, listen, their reason is they want a task force on long distance and safety, you know, road safety implemented. And it's more like self-regulation. If the trucks are not worthy being on the road, we could put them away. Can we reduce on the roadblocks so that we can have, you know, smooth flow of traffic? For a business person, at the end of the day, all this might not be of concern to you. But the question is, if these guys continue like this, what is going to happen to the supply of products that come from across the region into the country? We just hope that this can be aligned in real time. Welcome to the Business Show. All right, so much happening in the world of business this week. And there's a talk from Private Sector Foundation that are saying the recent directive by the Minister of Finance to impose some taxes on sugar imports could actually end up affecting the production in the country, with already a deficit that needs to be covered by the manufacturers here. We are waiting to see how that will turn out, because if the demand is high and supply is already low, you know what that will mean. The guys will probably hide the product, then hike the prices. We've been having sugar at less than 5K per kg. Now, if we have these taxes imposed, which PSFU say should have actually been, you know, should have, the government should have waited, because engagements were ongoing. So we just hope they can have answers to this soon, so the markets are not disrupted again. Otherwise, let's get the show started this week. And we'll be talking insurance and businesses in Views from the Top this week. Now, time and again, so much will happen for you as a business person. The uncertainties cannot be determined, but one thing can be for sure. If you have an insurance policy as a business person or as part of your business, then you are guaranteed that in the event that a fire or burglary or your cargo in transit gets affected by any calamities, you will be compensated. This week on Views from the Top, we want to speak to Charity Kabera, who is the client relationship executive at Eagle Africa, who tells us about why every SME needs to have an insurance policy for their business and how it could just help you keep on with the operations despite the challenges. This is Views from the Top.
Thank you for having me on the Business Show. My name is Charity Kabera. I'm the Client Relationship Manager, Eagle Africa Insurance Brokers Uganda Limited.
All right, Charity, let's have the conversation started this week with business and insurance. What runs into your mind, or what does the public get to understand when someone says business and insurance?
Business and insurance is a combination of two concepts. The process and activities that involved in running a business on one hand, and insurance being the protection that is offered to these activities and processes. Protection against financial risks. Yes, that's what I,
Okay, so I understand this breaks down to different, you know, sizes of businesses, let's say, or sectors, from manufacturing to the small and medium or the MSMEs. Maybe yes. Talk to us about that.
Okay. Insurance is tailor-made for all these organizations or businesses. Mm. One cover cannot cut across all these businesses. From what a manufacturing business requires is not the same as what an SME requires, but it all comes down to insurance protects their assets, their people against any risks that they may face.
Okay. For someone watching, the question should be, why should I sign up for insurance as a business person or as a business owner? Yes, why should I sign up for insurance?
There are a number of reasons why you would need insurance. One of them being peace of mind. You would not want to go to bed worried about your cargo that's coming from China. You'd not want to be worried about fire. So peace of mind is very crucial for a business person. You have other things to worry about, like the marketing, the selling of your merchandise and all. So insurance gives you peace of mind, and my goods are protected against any risks that may come. Insurance will also give you business continuity. In case you have your business has been faced with a calamity, say fire, say a burglary, say an accident on the way while your goods are being transported, insurance will come in to make sure that you're able to continue with your business. Insurance will also help in terms of legal requirements. We have the Workman's Compensation Act 2000, which stipulates that every employer should be able to compensate their employee in case of injuries while at work. So insurance comes in to make sure that this legal requirement is catered for.
Okay, yes. So that sounds more like a general aspect about insurance, but are there particular policies under insurance that are aligned or channeled towards businesses alone?
Yes, please. There are a number of policies, but I'll begin with the business or risks. Like I had earlier said, we tailor make insurance policies to fit every business, irrespective of what they do. But the business or risks caters for the fire, the material damage to your goods or to your building that houses your goods. In there we can have the burglary, we can also cover your employees against injuries while at work. Basically we tailor make this business or risks to meet your insurance needs. We would also have the marine, which will cover your goods right from the country where you purchase them all through to Mombasa and up to Kampala. So you would sit back, relax, and be sure that yes, you purchased your goods, but they are safe. In case of anything, insurance will be able to compensate.
Okay.
Yes.
Then,
the goods in transit policy would also help for inland transits of your goods from point A to point B within Uganda or across East Africa. Then we'll have the motor. Yes, motor comprehensive, motor trade for the people that are in the business of selling motor vehicles, in the business of the garages. Yes,
okay.
Those are the policies I would.
Right, great stuff. Let's talk about Ego Africa then, and how are you helping businesses or business owners understand how relevant it is to have any policy for insurance?
Well, as Ego Africa, we come down to the business to analyze your insurance needs. Like I have been saying that businesses are different, therefore the insurance that we give is different. So we come down to the business, we do the risk identification, we do the risk assessment to determine how much risk do you have and what insurance you need. So we do the education bit, where we educate the businesses, because some businesses think they don't need insurance. Others think it's very expensive. So we come down to the business person to show you what risk do you have and how we can help you mitigate this risk.
Okay.
Yes.
You talk about business community thinking insurance is expensive. If you could break down for the viewers the most, what you'd call the basic of what they can pay for a different policy under business.
It is hard to determine, because we will need to go down to the value, what goods or what services are you providing. And then, because our industry is regulated and we operate under minimum rates. So for every operation there's a rate. So it is hard to generalize what premium someone would pay. But it's a misconception out there that insurance is expensive. They can come to us and we will take them through, because everything is different from business to business.
Okay. So let me ask, if you go out there to speak to a business person before they decide whether or not they want to take a cover, what are some of the things you look out for so the business people can know, okay, this is what they will ask for before they can tell me how much I'm going to pay?
Okay. For example, we will need to know what you do, the kind of goods. If you're into goods, we'll know what kind of goods do you sell. How do you, is there any transport? Do you move them around the country? Do you have other branches? How many branches do you have? How are those goods stored? Are they in a warehouse? Are they in a, we look out for the business you do, the goods you sell, how you sell them, where you keep them, and their movements from point A to point B.
Advisory is, I think, one of the other common things that not so many people pay attention to in insurance. And I think Eagle does offer that.
Yes, please.
For starters, maybe what falls under advisory? And is it something that is very important for businesses, most of the SMEs?
Yes, advisory is very important, because first of all, it removes any misconception of insurance. What is involved in our advisory, first of all, is the risk identification, the risk assessment. We identify, we assess, and then now we start advising. We break it down to the policies that you need from what we have discovered. We break it down to your needs. We say, this is the risk that you're facing, this is what you need. Some of the risk mitigation measures may not even be insurance related. Yes, or maybe insurance, and you enhance, get this fire policy, but also install sprinklers, install fire extinguishers. So get down on the ground, identify, assess, and then start the mitigation, the risk mitigation measures.
Okay. Well, I guess it's clear for you as a business person, insurance shouldn't be seen as something that is meant for the rich. For you as a business person, if you can value how much your total investment is, and then ask the insurance company if they are going to insure your business, how much it will be worth. So in the event that anything happens, sit back and ask, will I be in a loss or not? I know for a fact that there are people downtown who run businesses, and I've said in the past, well, we've lost everything because of the fires and we didn't see this coming. But the question is, how many times have insurance companies come to you and try to talk to you about taking a policy to cover against any dangers that could happen in your business, and you probably just ignore or say, well, insurance is some kind of thuggery or stuff. it is high time you sat back and, you know, analyzed what you really want for your business and see if the safety matters a lot. And that is what Charity was talking about. Time now for a quick break on the program with me, Simon. Thank you so much for watching. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us on our socials, drop us comments. I'll see you after the break.